So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 24/7. Main hu Manish Mishra and in this session guys I will bring to you some more important questions from the PIB news. This session is beneficial for various government exams and specially it is important for ESI section of the RBI Grade B exam. To chaliye start karte hain with the session, but before we begin, if you are new here, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon, and also you can join this Telegram group for daily quiz and the daily sessions. All right, so let's begin with the question number 1. So question number 1 and 2 is about a report which is known as estimating the economic benefits of investment in monsoon mission and high performing computing facilities. So guys, there is a mission of the Ministry of Earth Sciences which is known as the National Monsoon Mission. It was augmented with the high performance computing facility in the year 2015. और उससे क्या बेनिफिट्स हुए उसको मैप करने के लिए, उसको एनालाइज करने के लिए दिस रिपोर्ट वाज पब्लिश्ड. ओके, लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द रिपोर्ट फर्स्ट. सो दिस रिपोर्ट गाइस हैज बीन पब्लिश्ड बाय NCAER, नेशनल काउंसिल ऑफ अप्लाइड एंड इकोनॉमिक रिसर्च, व्हिच इज नथिंग बट अ नॉट फॉर प्रॉफिट इकोनॉमिक पॉलिसी थिंक टैंक. इट इज अ इकोनॉमिक पॉलिसी थिंक टैंक है ये बेसिकली, और ये नॉट फॉर प्रॉफिट है. ओके, इकोनॉमिक पॉलिसी थिंक टैंक एंड द करंट प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ NCAER इज मिस्टर नंदन निलेकनी. आई होप आप सबने इनका नाम सुना होगा. नंदन निलेकनी इज द करंट प्रेसिडेंट एंड इट वॉज एस्टैब्लिश्ड वे बैक इन द ईयर 1956 में इसको एस्टैब्लिश किया गया था. एंड दिस रिपोर्ट हैज बीन पब्लिश्ड बाय द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड द रिपोर्ट एस्टिमेटिंग द इकोनॉमिक बेनिफिट्स ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट इन मॉनसून मिशन एंड हाई परफॉर्मिंग कंप्यूटिंग फैसिलिटीज. ओके, so before talking about the report, let's talk about what is this National Monsoon Mission. So guys, this mission was launched in the year 2012. Okay, it was launched in the year 2012 with a dual objective of seasonal and intra seasonal weather forecast. Okay, seasonal and intra seasonal weather forecast and also the medium range weather forecast. Okay, so it has dual objective, medium range weather forecast. So seasonal and intra seasonal weather forecasting and medium range weather forecasting is the objective of this National Monsoon Mission, which was launched in the year 2012 under the Ministry of Earth Sciences. Okay, and the implementing partner of under this mission is National Council of Medium Range Weather Forecasting, which is located in Noida, and it coordinates the efforts for the medium range weather forecast. Okay, iska kaam kya hai, jo medium range weather forecast hai wo dena. And then we have IITM Pune which coordinates the efforts for seasonal and intra seasonal weather forecasting. Okay, seasonal and intra seasonal weather forecasting. So we have discussed that there are two objective of this mission, seasonal and intra seasonal weather forecasting and medium range weather forecasting. So for seasonal and intra seasonal weather forecasting it is IITM Pune, while for medium range it is NCMRWF which is in Noida. Okay, and what IMD does, India Meteorological Organization, ye kya karta hai, ye in dono cheezo ko jo ye weather forecasting karte hain ye inko implement karne ka kaam karta hai, isko aage properly implement karta hai is forecasting ko. All right, so these are the three partners, implementing partner in the National Monsoon Mission. Okay, and now in the year 2015 mein kya hua tha, the National Monsoon Mission was augmented with the high performance computing facilities that has helped the country in achieving a paradigm shift in weather and climate modeling for operational weather forecast. All right, and total iske andar jo kharcha hua hai that is how much, approximately 1000 crore, which is exact amount is 990 crore, which is approximately how much, 1000 crores. All right, and now let's talk about the report. So first of all, if you talk about the sample, ki jo sample tha wo kitna bada tha, so 3965 crop farmers ke liye tha, were taken personal interview, 757 marine fishermen, 1376 livestock owners, and total district jahan pe ye survey kiya gaya, that is 173 district across the 16 states in all the agroclimatic zones of India, and there are 15 agroclimatic zones in India. Okay, and now let's talk about the key findings of the report. So 94% of the farmers and 53% of livestock owners are seeking weekly advisory. Okay, 94% farmers aise hain aur 53.7% livestock owners aise hain jinko weekly advisory chahiye instead of the seasonal advisory नेशनल मॉनसून मिशन के बाद, आफ्टर द नेशनल मॉनसून मिशन, पोस्ट नेशनल मॉनसून मिशन, 24% ऑफ फार्मर्स एंड 53.7% ऑफ लाइवस्टॉक ओनर्स आर सीकिंग वीकली एडवाइजरी. ओके, 80% ऑफ द फार्मर्स एंड 83% ऑफ द लाइवस्टॉक ओनर्स हु रिसीव्ड इंफॉर्मेशन ऑन नेचुरल कैलामिटीज रिपोर्टेड टू हैव डिक्रीज इन लॉसेस व्हिच अकर ड्यू टू दोस यू नो नेचुरल कैलामिटीज. ओके, 98% farmers and 76% of livestock owners made modifications to at least one of the critical practices based on this weather advisories. Okay, then jo average in annual income hai of the farming households which adopted no modification, jinhone koi bhi modification adopt nahi kiya based on these weather forecasting, unki jo average annual income hai, that is how much, rupees 1.98 lakh. But for those who adopted these modification, their average annual income is how much, rupees 3.02 lakh. Okay. Then 80% of the farmers and 83% of livestock owners who received information on natural calamities, ye to same point hai. Right, so this is the same point. Rupees 1.92 crore additional income was generated from the 1079 successful fishing expeditions made using the potential fishing zone advisories. Okay, income was generated in the fishing sector due to this national due to this augmentation of national monsoon mission and high performing computing facility. Okay, so these are, guys, the basic, you know, highlights of this report. And if you talk about the estimation of economic benefits, kiski wajah se economic benefits kya hua, so rupees 50,447 crore is the total benefit to the agricultural household and the fishermen. Lagbhag 50,000 crore ka economic benefits hai, economic benefit hua hai to the to the farmers and the fishermen. About 26.6% of the total benefits has been given to the women farmers, and with an initial investment of rupees 1000 crore, national monsoon mission and HPC facilities result in a 50-fold increase. Matlab jo initial investment tha, we have discussed this, kitna tha, rupees 990 crore, which is approximately 1000 crore, aur usse hame jo economic benefit mila wo kitna tha, 50,447 crore, which is approximately 50 times of the initial investment. So, ये काफी अच्छी रिपोर्ट है. And this fact, guys, is the most important. ये आपके एग्जाम में जरूर पूछा जा सकता है कि इनिशियल इन्वेस्टमेंट कितनी थी, approximately 1000 crore की, तो उसमें कितना इकोनॉमिक बेनिफिट हमें मिला इन द फार्मिंग सेक्टर, इन द यू नो लाइफ स्टॉक सेक्टर, इन द फिशिंग सेक्टर. सो इट इज 50 टाइम्स, दैट इज 50,447 crores. Okay. So this was about this report, guys. Now let's come back to the question number 1 and 2. So question number 1 is, which of the following organizations has released the report? So this report has been released by the National Council of Applied and Economic Research. Option A will be the correct answer here. And then we have question number 2. So we have to identify the correct statements. 94% of farmers and 53.7% of livestock owners are seeking weekly advisory. Yes, this is absolutely correct. After the implementation, after the augmentation of national monsoon mission and the high performing computing facility, 80% of the farmers and 83% of livestock owners who received information on natural calamities reported to have reduced losses occurring due to them. This is also correct, guys. And 98% farmers and 76% of livestock owners made modifications to at least one of the critical practices based on the weather advisory. This is also correct, which means all are correct. We have to find the correct statement. So this should be all are correct. So option E, all are correct, will be the correct answer. And remember, you have to memorize two or three things very importantly in this report. One is that this annual income wala point, that jinhone modifications apnaya hai, unka annual income zyada hai as compared to those jinhone nahi apnaya hai. Then you have to remember this point where the economic benefits has become 50 times of the initial investment, right? And this is also very important. And some basic facts about, of course, the national monsoon mission. And now let's come to the question number 3. So there is a challenge which is known as COVID-19 Shri Shakti challenge, that was organized by MyGov platform in collaboration with Dash to encourage and involve women-led startups to come up with innovative solutions that can help in the fight against COVID-19. So you have to fill this gap, that Shri Shakti challenge was organized by MyGov platform in collaboration with which organization, right? So let's discuss about this challenge, guys. So it was organized by MyGov platform in collaboration with United Nations Women. Okay, United Nations Women ke saath. And it has been organized to encourage and evolve women-led startups to come up with innovative solutions that can help in the fight against COVID-19. All right. And if you talk about the challenge, so these are some important points from the challenge. Agar aapko yaad rehta hai, then that is very good. So the challenge was implemented in the two stages. One is ideation stage, then we have proof of concept. And the challenge received a response. Total response kitna hai? Isme 1265 entries. That is not important for exam, but yes, this is just for the basic understanding. And these are the four parameters on which the startups were given awards, and which are innovation, usability, relevance, and impact of idea on the society. Okay, so these are the four parameters: innovation, usability, relevance, and impact of idea on the society. These are the four parameters. Or three startups aise the jinko award diya gaya. They were declared as the winner, and the three startups were declared as the promising solutions by the United Nations Women. And the three startups who won this challenge were given rupees 5 lakh each, while for the three promising solution startups, the prize money was how much? Rupees 10 lakh. All right. So this was about this news, guys. Let's come back to the question. So the question is what? My GOV in collaboration with Dash. So this is United Nations Women. And United Nations Women ke baare mein agar baat karein, to it is also known as United Nations Entity for Women Empowerment. United Nations Entity for Women Empowerment. It was, you know, started in the year 2011. ये 2011 में start हुआ था. इसके अलावा, if you talk about more, so Fumzile Mlambo, yes, Fumzile Mlambo is the current chief of United Nations Women. It is headquartered in New York. Okay. So and talking about all of these organizations, so UNESCO, it is headquartered in Paris. Current chief is Audrey Azoulay. United Nations headquartered in New York. Antonio Guterres is the current chief. UNDP, Asian Steiner is the current chief. It is also headquartered in New York. United Nations Women, we have discussed. United Nations Environment Program, it is headquartered in Nairobi, which is the capital of Kenya. And Inger Andersen, she is the chief of United Nations Environment Program. She is from Netherlands. And talking about Netherlands, so there is a company of Netherlands which is known as PAL-V, which is a flying car making company. It is setting up its plant in Gujarat. Okay, so these are some basic point about these. And so can you tell me from Netherlands? मेरे को एक person का नाम याद आता है. So recently Denmark Open हुआ है 2020, which is a prestigious open of the badminton. So Denmark Open में मेन सिंगल में एक नीदरलैंड्स के एक पर्सन ने गोल्ड मेडल जीता है. कैन यू नेम दैट पर्सन? राइट डाउन इन द कमेंट्स. ओके, इन द फीमेल सेक्शन इट इज, इन द वुमेन सिंगल्स इट इज नोजोमी ओकुहारा. शी इज फ्रॉम जापान. एंड यू हैव टू टेल मी द नेम अबाउट द मेन सिंगल गोल्ड मेडल विनर. ओके, सो नाउ लेट्स कम टू द क्वेश्चन नंबर 4, गाइज. क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 इज, अर्बन मोबिलिटी इंडिया कॉन्फ्रेंस विल बी ऑर्गेनाइज बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हाउसिंग एंड अर्बन अफेयर्स, which is headed by Mr. Hardeep Singh Puri, and he is also the Minister of Civil Aviation. So question is, what is the core of the conference? So guys, it will be organized in the month of November, this month only, on the 9th day. 9th November 2020 ko isko organize kiya jayega. We will discuss about it more in detail after the event will be over. So it will be organized by Minister of Housing and Urban Affairs, and it will be the 13th edition with the theme Emerging Trends in Urban Mobility. Okay, what is the theme? Emerging trends in urban mobility, and to focus on innovative measures taken at national and international level to address the challenges posed by COVID-19, to provide accessible and convenient transport to the people. It is the objective of this conference, which is known as Urban Mobility India Conference. Okay, and iske bare mein detail mein hum padhenge after the event. All right. So let's come back to the question. So the question is, what is the theme of the conference? Yes, so the theme of the conference, guys, is what? Option A, emerging trends in urban mobility. And remember one thing here, that this conference will be chaired by Durga Shankar. He is the secretary in the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. All right, so this was about this news, guys, and that's it for the session. I hope the session is clear, and if you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Milte hain kal ke session mein. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.